What is a tadpole and what role do they play in the environment? The name tadpole comes from Old English. Tad, meaning toad, and pole, meaning head. Toadhead, as they look a bit like a large head with a tail. A tadpole is the larval stage of the frog life cycle. So nearly all frogs start out their lives as tadpoles. Most frogs lay their eggs in water. Some species, such as the Victorian smooth froglet, lay their eggs on land and then wait for winter rains to flood their habitats. Marsh frogs, on the other hand, lay hundreds of eggs among the plants on the surface of the pond and whip them into a foam egg mass. Common froglets typically lay eggs individually or in small groups attached to leaves and sticks on the bottom of the pond. Tree frogs lay numerous small eggs in a fluid jelly sac that is typically attached to submerged plant stems and sticks, laid in clumps floating on the surface or spread out over the bottom of the pond. Spawn is the term used to describe the eggs and the jelly mass that surrounds them. Once laid, frog eggs soon hatch into tiny, vulnerable tadpoles. These tadpoles may feed on the remaining egg mass before beginning to graze on algae, all the while growing and developing distinctive features. Fun fact, frog ponds generally need to develop algae and aquatic plants before they're suitable for tadpoles. Tadpoles live in water and absorb oxygen from the water through gills like a fish. Unlike frogs, tadpoles have tails as well as horny jaws made of keratin, surrounded by rows of bristly teeth on an oral disc. They use this to graze on algae, decaying plant matter, and aquatic plants. Tadpoles of each frog species mostly have a unique appearance, which can help you determine what general group of frogs you have in your pond. Ground frogs. Tadpoles of the common froglet and marsh frog species generally have bodies that are wider than they are tall. They are typically bottom dwellers, benthic, feeding and hiding among leaf litter at the bottom of ponds. When they swim, they wiggle their whole tail. Their eyes are in from the side of their head. Tree frogs. Tadpoles of southern brown tree frogs and whistling tree frogs typically have bodies that are taller than they are wide. They hover in the water column head up near the surface. When they swim, they just wiggle the tips of their tails unless startled and fleeing from predators. Their eyes are right on the edge of their head. As tadpoles grow, they gradually undergo a process called metamorphosis. Many species initially have external gills when they hatch. However, these are soon covered under skin flaps. Sunlight and warming water temperatures are important components of any successful frog pond. Tadpoles in cold, shaded ponds will generally develop much more slowly than those in open, sunny sites and warmer climates. Hind limbs gradually appear, followed by forelimbs. The head and jaw changes shape to resemble that of a frog, while the tail remains. Gradually, lungs develop to replace the gills, and the tail shrinks in towards the body as it is reabsorbed, providing sustenance for the metamorph until it can catch its own food. The young frog, usually less than half the size of the adult, is known as a metamorph through this final process. It will emerge from the water and begin its life on land, transitioning to a predatory diet of insects. Did you know, tadpoles help support wetland ecosystems? Tadpoles play an important role linking land and wetland food chains. Tadpoles graze on algae, which helps regulate the growth of algae. Tadpoles in turn become food for predatory water bugs and wetland birds, helping support the presence of these creatures at wetlands. We can all play a role in protecting tadpole habitats, helping them make the journey to adult frog. Here are some important points. All frogs, tadpoles and frog spawn are protected in Victoria. The collection of frogs from the wild or release of frogs to the wild is prohibited under the Victorian Wildlife Regulations. These regulations encourage the protection of wild populations from illegal collection and introduction of disease and genetic contamination. If you have built your own frog pond, you will need to wait for frogs to naturally colonise it. You should not collect frogs from the wild or purchase captive frogs and release them in the wild. You can access our full set of tadpole learning resources from the Melbourne Water Frog Census website. Melbourne Water is the caretaker of Melbourne's wetlands and waterways, which are key habitats for frog populations. Through our healthy waterway strategy, we work to improve the health of frog habitats and support you to act for frogs through our frog census,